September 5, 1814. My beloved, I do not know whether these transient meetings produce not as much pain as pleasure. And what have I said? I do not mean it. I will not forget the sweet moments when I saw your eyes, the divine rapture of the few and fleeting kisses. Yet indeed this must cease. Indeed, we must not part thus wretchedly to meet amidst the comfortless tumult of business. To part, I know not how. Well, dearest love, tomorrow. Tomorrow night. That eternal clock. Oh, that I could fright the steeds of lazy paced time. I do not think that I am less impatient now than formerly to repossess, to entirely engross my own treasured love. It seems so unworthy a cause for the slightest separation. I could reconcile it to my own feelings to go to prison, if they would cease to persecute us with interruptions. I must return. Your thoughts alone can waken mine to energy. My mind, without yours, is dead and cold as the dark midnight river when the moon is down. It seems as if you alone could shield me from impurity and vice. If I were absent from you long, I should shudder with horror at myself. My understanding becomes undisciplined without you. How divinely sweet a task it is to imitate each other's excellences, and each moment to become wiser in this surpassing love, so that, constituting but one being, all real knowledge may be comprised in the maxim, know thyself, with infinitely more justice than in its narrow and common application. Your affectionate Percy Shelley.